As FlutterFlow natively supports post notification using Firebase cloud messaging. However, some of you guys are asking for OneSignal integration in the community. So here it is. Let's learn how to set up OneSignal post notification in FlutterFlow using custom code. Let me show you the demo of a working OneSignal integration. Let me send a notification to this app. And this is running on a real device because we can't test notification on test mode. So OneSignal gives us a very user-friendly dashboard for sending notification and also provide an API to send notification programmatically. That means we can automate notification easily and integrate it within our app using API calls. Also, if you're using Supabase, then you can use edge function to trigger notification to specific users for specific events. So let's see how to achieve this in FlutterFlow. I assume you already have an OneSignal account. Now let's create an app in OneSignal by clicking on the new app button. Write your app name. Now select Google Android AppCM. Next. Here we need to upload Firebase service account JSON file. Let's retrieve our service account from Firebase. Open your Firebase console, select your project. Click on the setting icon to open project setting. Go to the service account tab menu. Here we need to generate a new key by clicking generate key button. Now that we have our service account JSON file, let's upload it on OneSignal. So click choose file and upload the downloaded service account key here. Then click save and continue. Next, we need to select Flutter because it is a Flutter project. Save and continue. Now we have obtained our OneSignal app ID, which we will use in our app later. Now let's open FlutterFlow. Here I have already created an app project. You can use any of your projects to follow along. Now navigate to the custom code section. In this section, we need to add new custom code. Click on add button and select action. Now let's give a name to our action. OneSignal. Paste the provided code in the editor. Also add the PubSpec dependency. Next, we need to make a small modification in the action code. We just need to replace the app ID with our generated OneSignal app ID. Let me replace it. For this demo, the app ID is hard-coded here. However, for a production app, it is recommended to store the app ID in the app state variable. Storing sensitive information like the app ID directly in the code is not secure. Now I have added the app ID. Let's save our action. Let's compile the code so we can use it in the app. The code has been successfully compiled. Now go to the main.dart section. Add one signal action in the initial action of main.dart. Now we are done from this side. Now let's test if it's working. We can't test this in test mode, so we need to use a real device. Download the APK and install it on your real device. After downloading, I have installed the app. Now let's open it. It's asking for permission to send notification. Let's allow it. Now let's open OneSignal and click check subscribe user to verify if it's working or not. As you can see, it's working. Here is my device and it shows that I can send notification to that user. So let's test it by clicking send a message button. Let's write something here. Test message. Click review and send. Here it shows that we only have one user that we can send a notification to. So let's send it. We have successfully sent a notification. Here on the phone you can see the notification has arrived instantly. Now let's send a notification with an image. Create a new push notification and write the message name. Add a title and message. Let's select an image. You can upload any image you want, but I'm going to use web search. Okay, so let's search for OneSignal. I like this one, so let's save it. Okay, so let's send it. Here you can see that our app received the notification with the image we selected. Now let's send an in-app notification. Select in-app, new message, new in-app. Enter a message name for the in-app notification. Here you can design your in-app notification using a blog editor or an HTML editor. For this demo, I will be choosing the blog editor. But before sending the notification, let's add a test user so we can instantly test our in-app notification. Click on send test in-app, add test user, select the user, add to test subscription. Name the test user and then add it. Now let's refresh the list. Let's select an image here. Let's send it to our test user. Here you can see our in-app notification is also working. Thanks for watching. If you found this tutorial helpful, please like the video and consider subscribing to our channel for more FlutterFlow tutorials and updates. If you have any question or suggestion, feel free to leave a comment below. Keep building awesome apps.